What's up, everyone? It's Russo. I hope everyone is doing well. Please follow my Instagram at RussoLifts. Just in case something happens to this YouTube channel, you can follow, message, and you can watch my daily story content on Instagram. I'll see you there.
All right, you guys. So I shall deliver. It is day 3 of the SARM cycle, aka just loading it. Nothing's happening. I guess I'll give you a physique update, even though this has nothing to do with the SARM I'm taking because nothing's happening yet. If you want to know the weight, I don't know because I weigh myself at the gym because my scale's busted at home, and it really sucks weighing myself at the gym because it depends on the amount of food I ate, you know, did I carb up for this meal? Etc. etc. So I really don't have an accurate weight. It's around 200 pounds. I think I'm in the 190. Can I go out on a limb? Say 197, 199.
No chest. Where's the chest at, Russo? Where's it at?
Maybe one day my chest will grow. So I'm guessing you guys want to know what SARM I'm doing. It's none of the new ones that just came out, although they have a lot of promise. I'm not gonna be the number one test guinea pig for that shit, that's for sure. It's not S4, it's not LGD. I heard LGD shuts you off a tiny bit more than the one I'm using, which is, you guessed it, the most commonly used SARM, OSTARINE. And the reasoning behind using this one is completely obvious. The most people used it. This is the most studied one, I think. You know, there's a lot of actual research out on it now. I was watching a video a few weeks ago saying there was actually human trials on it, but of course it wasn't with like healthy human males, it was with low T males. So, you know, research is research, but that research is important because it showed the risk of using it, and I am fucking well aware of them. I sound like Rich Piana already. You know, fucking the best scenario is for me to use OSTARINE. You know, this meal doesn't count, it's a fucking snack. But where was I? Yeah, I'm using OSTARINE. I'm not gonna tell you the source because I am not promoting this shit. I am not condoning the use of this shit, nor do I encourage anyone to use this shit. Again, I'm sounding like Rich Piana. You start talking about this stuff, you know, Rich Piana just slowly starts creeping out. All right, man, no chest every time. Anyways. Gonna be doing some supplement shopping on, oh my camera, tripod, supplementwarehouse.com. I gotta do it real quick, get some creatine, and then it's off to school, and I gotta brush off the trap mobile, and then I will be out. That shirt though, don't stop believing. You gotta give a thumbs up on this video, at least for the shirt. And then, I don't really show off my outfit. Yep. Rocking this shirt. Yeah. I got my joggers. Woo. And I got the Nikes. Woo. Feeling like $1,000. Right, Bolt? Say hello to YouTube. You're like, why the fuck is this camera shoved in my face? I hate snow. Alright, classes are over. Say it was a pretty good day. Besides the fact that I got shitted on by my math test. But other than that, it was good. At the gym.
gonna make my pre-workout, and it's gonna be 1.5 PhenoFlex Stimulate. This chick's like, why are you recording yourself? I'm making a YouTube video. Duh. But yeah, I can't take 2 scoops of this. That's how strong it is. You know, Mr. Hyde, 2 scoops. You know, NitroFlex, 2 scoops. This shit, 2 scoops, and it's too much. So 1.5 is the sweet spot. Gonna train upper back. Did not remember to bring my extra battery. Do not know how long this camera is gonna make it through that. This chick is still staring at me. Quit it. You're making me feel uncomfortable. I vlog. But yeah, 1.5. This stuff is like off the charts, crazy strong. Listen, I'm not paid by them either. This stuff, I don't know what the hell is in this. Like, stronger than Mr. Hyde. Trust me, I religiously took 2 scoops for like 3 months straight. Anyways, let's go hit some upper back. It's my favorite day to hit. Let's go. Back workout complete. What do I think of the workout? Personally, I thought I looked really flat today. And even in the posing footage, I looked flat. I just felt small and flat today. I don't know if that's psychological or my nutrition wasn't on point today. I had about the same amount of calories. I've been saving all my calories for night ever since I started dieting. That's how I've been doing it, is I pick out at night, kind of don't really eat that much throughout the day, and I've been fine with training back. My strength was pretty much the same. I was very happy yet disappointed at the same time. When I went up to 6 plates for rack pulls, I was happy because I think it was either 4, I think it was 4 reps, I don't know, I have to go check the video, of when I did 6 plates on that exact rack at 215 pounds. Well, I did it for 3 reps today at around, again, 197 to 199. I didn't weigh myself today, I should have, oh well. I was disappointed because, number one, I really didn't psych myself up enough. I kind of psyched myself out, actually. I was like, oh my god, this is 6 plates. You know, you can't do that. You just gotta get pissed and pull that shit off the rack. Okay? So, the reps were shitty looking too, but I still think that's pretty good considering the deficit I'm in. And considering I'm so much lighter than when I did that last time. Not to mention I did all my sets going up to that. I just didn't throw on, you know, 1 plate, do 1 rep, 2 plates, do 1. No, I didn't max that out. I just did that after all my shrug work and all my regular rack pull work. I just pulled that AMRAP of 6 plates. Other than that, you know, upper back I'm really strong with. Nothing out of the ordinary. The posing footage, I looked flat as fuck. I looked small. I kind of lost my pump at that point. Not that I really had a big one to begin with. And yeah, I just didn't. I look leaner compared to last footage. Go check last posing footage in that exact same area. And you'll notice I look leaner. I've been working on my abs. I just can't do them before legs because I'll fuck with my abs. But I've been working my abs pretty relentlessly lately. Abs, I just genetically, I don't have abs that like pop out, so I'm really trying to bring those up. And I'll go into another video of why I don't train abs as much as I used to. I had to go to the doctors twice because I was training abs too much and I ended up straining my abs doing beltless work. So that's why
kind of limit my abs, but gonna start doing them more, try and make them pop a little bit more. But yeah, I would take this as a baseline. You know, I really didn't look that big on camera. I really didn't feel that big in person today. It was just an off day. Still rack pulled 6 plates. I actually did a little bit of quad and hamstring work, just some pump up at the end because my leg day was so shitty last time I did legs. Post-workout meal, I'm hungry.
So I hope you enjoyed today's daily vlog, and I apologize, it's not what I wanted it to turn out to be, but that's what happens when you upload every single day. Especially I'm gonna devote my time to doing this, you know, not everything's gonna be excited. I have other stuff to do. I have a bunch of college work that needs to get done right after I edit this, and it's just tough to make videos every single day. And I forgot my camera battery. I really wanted to record the workout so I'd have something to talk over, but I didn't. So instead, leave me a question to talk about tomorrow. Or yeah, just leave me a question about what I'm doing and I'll try to answer it the best I can. You know, just my opinion the best I can. But please stick around, subscribe. I'm really trying to grow this YouTube channel, this YouTube fitness channel, based on complete honesty, no lying, no bullshit.